The Uniform Cost Search Challenge. Are the implementations of Uniform Cost Search optimal? Well, we looked online and did a Google search and found the top 20 websites of Uniform Cost Search and Python. And only 5 of these had working code. So we tested this code of the 5 websites. Spoiler alert, the answer is yes or no, depending on some insight. And the insight we'll give you in this video. So keep watching. Let's look at the first system. Here is the code for system 1. We can go through the code if you want to look at it. And this is the original code. When we run it, it does work. The first system used this graph. So we changed the weights on these graph to see what stopping mechanism it had. When did it stop? We're going from S to node 6. So these weights mean we have the lowest cost of 9 if we go this route. Will it find 9 or will it find 10, which is a simple route from start to 3 to 6? When we used our contrived example, so we've changed the weights to see will it find the shortest distance, it has the minimum cost of 10, so it did not find the shortest path. Now, system 2, we go back to our original graph that we had the problem. Remember that the correct answer going from 1 to 9 had a cost of 8, but we found a problem with the stopping mechanism that actually found a cost of 12. We have system 2. We have the original code. Let's run this as quite quickly, but we can see the code here, and there's quite a lot of code, but it does work. Now we've changed it to our original graph. So will it find the shortest route of, the cost of 8 was the correct shortest path, and the incorrect one that was found was 12. So when we run this code with the graph, let's see what it finds. Does it find 8 or 12? And it's going through all the nodes and it's reached its goal. Oh, the cost is 12. The third system had a completely different graph. Here's the graph that it used. Now again, we changed the weights to see if we could test when it would stop. So in this example, we created this route. So instead of going from node 6 to 7, which is the goal node, it goes from 6 to 4 to 7, which is cheaper. So going from the top start node of 0 to the goal node of 7, slightly cheaper route. Now what does this algorithm do? System 3, we check to see if the code works, and here is the code for system 3, and you can see the output, it works correctly. Now we change this, so instead of going straight from 6 to 7, the goal node is 7, we go from 6 to 4 to 7 for the shortest route. So does this find it? No, it does not. It goes straight from 0, 1, 3, 6, and 7, where the shortest route would be a cost of 7, would go 0, 1, 3, 6, 4, 7. Now the last two examples are slightly different. Let's have a look at the fourth system. Here we've got these Turkish cities and the distance, I believe in kilometres, between them. So what we did, we just changed some weights from two cities and the weights in between them. So in this example, you can see we've got 30, 30, 30. So a distance of 90 kilometers, which is shorter than 110. So if we go between the example cities, we have a shorter route. This is just a way to test the algorithm. Now, system 4 is slightly different. We can look through the code. And remember, this one finds the distance between cities. It's slightly different because when we run it, you can see here it asks enter roadmap path, and what that requires is a file, a CSV file with the distances. Now we can put in what start city we want, and also we can say what our goal city is. So when we run that, you can see it correctly gives us the best route. So that does work. So that's good. That was system 4. Now, system 5 was very similar. We again have cities, and this was defined in a slightly different way, and it's a bit more complicated to explain details, but essentially we're looking at distances and shortest distance between cities. I believe this would be Romania. We did the same thing, we created a shorter route, and it correctly found the answer. Anyway, we changed some of the distances to see when the algorithm will stop, and when we run it, we can see the original distance was cost 418, but we added this shorter route and the algorithm did find it. So with algorithm 4 and 5, they did find the shortest distance. One thing you might notice here, if we look through, you can see, for example, Arad and Zerind, we define the distances between the two cities twice. Why do we do that? Now, if we go back to our first system, we can remember we ran it and it didn't find the shortest path. It said minimum cost from 0 to 6 was 10. Now, that's only with a directed graph. What happens if we add the edges? So we've got the reverse edges now, so 0 to 1, 1 to 0. So the arrows would go both ways, if you like. It's not directed, it's bi-directional. And also we've put the costs in. So the costs are the same, but from 1 to 0 is now 0 to 1. So essentially the graph is the same, the weights are the same, but we've just defined both directions. Now let's run it. Now you can see we've found the shortest distance. So the code is correct. It's correct for the example, but the example only shows the directed graph. The uniform cost search to find its goal, you have to make the graph not directional, so bi-directional, if you like. So the arrows have to go both ways. And system 2, also directed, we can define the graph with the edges going both ways. And let's see on our graph that incorrectly found a minimal cost of 12, which is not correct. We wanted the shortest route of 8, the cost of 8. Let's have a look. Let's see if we define the reversed edges. So 1 to 2 goes to 2 to 1. Same costs. Now let's run the algorithm. Let's see. Does it find the shortest cost of 8? Or does it still have a cost of 12? It's going through all of the nodes. Now, this is going to take longer, because instead of a short, simple version where each edge is only going in one direction, here it's got to expand the nodes when you're going from the nodes forwards and backwards, if you like. So it has to expand the nodes more times. It's still doing it, so it's taking its time. So it is more complicated if you define the edges in both directions. But we want to see if the uniform cost search actually works. Is it optimal? And find the correct shortest path of 8. Let's have a look. Surely we must be coming to the... Here we go. Yes, we've reached a goal cost of 8. So again, this system, system 2, does work if we define both directions of each edge. Now, system 3, we can add some more edges so they defined in both directions. Let's take these comment signs out. So now instead of having 01367, we're looking for 013647. So the cost is 7 for the shortest path. Well, that was quick and it was correct. So again, when we define the graph correctly, not just one direction but both, for each edge, the uniform cost search does work correctly. So let's go back to our original code. When we run Dijkstra's algorithm, we correctly find the correct shortest path and minimum costs. But when we ran the uniform cost search, we had the error with node 9. Now, what we can do is we can add more definitions to the graph. So now we've got the reverse directions. So 1, 2 with a cost of 3, 2 to node 1 with a cost of 3. And now when we run the uniform cost search, it correctly finds the minimum distance to node 9, which has the minimum cost of 8. So essentially what we're saying is that when you go online, the examples are not complete. The algorithm is optimal, but the examples use directed graphs because they're simpler. But if you want them to work correctly, you need to define each edge in both directions. Now, this is neither shown, explained, or even included in any of the websites. I hope you enjoyed that video, and I hope you enjoyed that insight, because the comment that we got was correct and we wanted to correct our videos because they could be interpreted as the algorithm was wrong. But the algorithm and the code was correct, but the graph has to be in both directions.